glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's still early in the season, but a lot can be learned from early matchups in conference play. Time to take you out to the Pac-12. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
USC campus. We're in Los Angeles, California, and today should be a good one, folks.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
USC has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Run, and he's brought down. Brought down at the 25.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
Third down and 6 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Swanson is the punter. Heading for the corner, and he's tackled at the 43.
The Trojans right now, Kirk, I think they've just got to play within themselves. Sometimes you get at home and you get just a little bit too fired up at the beginning of a game.
I agree with you. I think sometimes there's a tendency for certain teams to press a little bit because they're trying so hard to keep this home crowd in the game, and they've been waiting all week and they're so excited. Sometimes you force a play. Let's let the play naturally come to you and react to it. So we'll see if this team playing at home jumps the gun a little bit or if they just let the game come to them.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 43.
Mike 56, Mike 56. I got you, boy. I got you, boy.
They hand it off. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Just throws this one away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From the 28-yard line, second down. Caught, and he's hit immediately.
Call it a gain of 1 yard.
Man left, man left.
Third down.
Three down. Mike 56.
This one's going deep to the end zone. Got his man. Touchdown. What a strike for the score.
And he did a nice job of looking off his defenders.
Converts the extra point. A five-play, 44-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
King gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 22. USC's really got things working right now for them. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Gets it. He's in space. They complete the play-action pass for a pickup of 3. From their own 23-yard line, third down. Under pressure. As a man, he'll lose big yards. They couldn't get anything to work, and it will be fourth down.
They did a pretty good job of not letting the offense get much going on that possession.
Swanson is waiting for the snap. Tackle at the 41-yard line. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence. I think this offense right now has a ton of confidence because their offense seems to be in sync. Anytime you can run the football and mix in play-action pass, it puts a lot of pressure on the defense. And right now, well, you can almost feel this offense's confidence growing, as we saw in that last play.
Gatewood, the ball carrier. He's knocked out of bounds around the 7-yard line. That makes it 7-6. USC is up a score. They get nice yardage on that run. Flings it to his tight end, but he drops it. They're going to go for the easy 3 here. USC is hoping to make this a 2-score game. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Doty from the 1 at the 30. He's taken down at the 36-yard line.
USC's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out?
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. On the catch, and he steps out. Watkins picks them up about 5 yards on that pass play, and that one will move the sticks.
It took some composure on the quarterback's part here to stand in there and make the throw with the blitz coming in. Well done.
He has some room. Tackle at the 43-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
And he just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He can run. He's at the 20, to the 10. He scores. What a play. Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. He makes the PAT. Colorado State is ready to kick it away. And down he goes at the 33. The quarterback leads his squad back out. They got three on their last possession. USC has a three-point lead. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
That brings up second and nine.
Fires quick, tipped.
Great play here by the linebacker to be able to read the pass, get back into the passing lane, and get up and knock that football away from the receiver.
Now it's third and nine coming up. Ball on the 34. Butler was the intended target. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
This is a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Fry to punt. He dropped it. Folks, that's the end of quarter number one, and we got a pretty good ball game on our hands so far. The Trojans with a three-point lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Tackled after a decent pickup. And he's hit hard immediately.
That'll bring up third and four.
Fires it out, and down he goes at the 7 yard line. USC holds a field goal lead. Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the seven. Nice run to the outside. And he hits him hard at the 1 yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Tackle made at the 35-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Quick throw, and they push him out
at about the 43-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Makes it out to about the 46. What a play.
Just a simple option play here. The quarterback gives it up, and they get good yardage. Great play.
He's tackled at the 44. It out to him again, and he's taken down
right around the 38-yard line.
He's at the 30, and they make the stop
around the 28-yard line.
First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation.
Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 14. They'll get the first down on that 8-yard completion.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Jones picks up about 4 yards after keeping the ball on the option. From the 10-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a 5-wide set. Down at the 12-yard line.
This guy's out of his stance so quickly that he's really a nightmare to try to block. They found out right here on this play.
This is the 11th play of this drive. He's taken down
around the 16-yard line.
Drop back 4 yards on that one.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points.
kicks up, and it's through the uprights. Colorado State to kick. Tackle made at the 33-yard line. The Trojans, over the years, have had great quarterbacks. They've got another one. He's proving to be that here in the first half, and he's the true leader of this group right now.
Leadership. You hit the nail right on the head. This team is moving the football, but it has everything to do with this young man and what he's been able to do for them. Because, again, he's making great throws. He's making good checks in the line of scrimmage. The thing that's standing out to me is his leadership and the way this team responds to that leadership. And that's why this team right now has played as well as they have.
Now that's how you run a corner route. He exploded out of his cut and beat the man coverage for a new set of downs.
From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line. USC is going to have to use their second timeout of the half. USC is up a field goal. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
That brings up third and 14.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. He lets it fly. Almost picked off.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Doty, back to return it. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He has some room. Very good tackle in space. So at the end of the half, USC leads it 13-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Let's not get too carried away by the stats in the first half, but it is noteworthy. Less than 6 yards per pass attempt. Now, we talk to coaches around the country. They always want those explosive plays, big chunk plays. Not getting it in this game. Might be an indication there's not really that deep threat that strikes fear into the defense on the outside.
The hardest thing for a corner is always facing a speedster, facing somebody that can stretch the field, because then it makes you backpedal and really makes you, you know, take away that deep ball first and bail out of there. And then sometimes it opens up the underneath stuff where you give a cushion to a receiver. So I think the offense has to find playmakers. They got to find ways to take shots, run some different routes, to find some creative ways to get some guys open, because right now, the little dink and dunk stuff isn't working. You're not threatening me down the field. I don't need to cover the whole field. We're bringing everybody up near the line of scrimmage and just taking away the short stuff.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's out to the 30. And he's taken down at the 31-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. USC is up by 3. Here's the halfback on the screen. Tackle at the 47. Knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Receiver.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Caught with room to work, and down he goes at the 35. There's a strike complete. Tackle made at about the 31.
That'll make it 31.
Pitches back. Looking for the corner. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
USC has a three-point lead. Touchdown.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he converts the extra point. It was an 8-play, 68-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken at the 5. He's taken down at the 22. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And off up the middle, and he's stuffed. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on their own 20. It middle to the running back, and he's stopped behind the line. Swanson awaits the snap. He's tackled at the 50-yard line.
You're always looking for the home run return, the big highlight. Didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
From the 41-yard line, second down. He fires right side.
Number 11 was the intended receiver on the way. That makes it third and 15.
Throws in a hurry. Good open field tackle. Inside handoff. And he is drilled at the 4-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
They bring him down in the backfield.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
They'll line it up again on third down. He's tackled around the 4-yard line. And he's taken down right around the 2-yard line. That quickly incomplete. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Touchdown, USC. The extra point. King has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He just drills this one. Roach's play so far in this football game, he's really the definition of just being a solid competitor every week.
Yeah, I mean, you and I have been watching him, and just every week he's impressed us, and then to be able to sit down and talk with him, I think that's the thing that really I took away from our meeting, is not just is this guy a talented player, but how competitive he is. And we've seen that again in this football game, just his competitive spirit leading this team, and up to this point, just a flawless performance.
Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
From their own 14-yard line, first down. Zips it to the back, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. 3-yard loss there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That'll make it second and goal.
Three down and one to go. The Trojans lead it by 17. He scrambled. And he's level at the 9. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Steps out of bounds at the 21-yard line.
They shut that drive down pretty emphatically. That's something to build on.
Swanson is the punter. He's at midfield. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Grabs it and hammered right there. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line.
That'll make it third and one.
And he's tackled right around the 24-yard line. Gets it out in a hurry. He came down with it. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A four-play, 45-yard drive. And a touchdown's a result. USC is ready to kick it away. Doty fields it at the two. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. USC's defense has been a force to be reckoned with, especially this game.
Well, they've stepped up today. They just seem to be dialed into what this offense is trying to do. Good job against the run. They've been very physical. What I love is how relentless they run to the football.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Brought down around the 40-yard line. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Goes to his back, and it's in and out of his hands.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Nine times out of ten, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence. But let's see if that carries them back down the field.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something. Because right now, the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
It's first down. They've got four cracks at it inside the five. It's first and goal. Bring him down at the two.
That's a gain of three on the play. That brings up second and goal.
Second down and goal. 2 yards to the end zone.
Complete touchdown.
USC's star is shining as brightly as he ever has.
It is fun to watch a quarterback do all the preparation, all the work that he needs to be able to do to put himself in a position to mentally and physically have a shot to win the game for his team. And that's exactly what we just saw.
And he tacks on the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 39-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. King gets set to kick this one away. Doty has it at the five. Trojans have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He's taken down at about the 27-yard line. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. From their own 27-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's to the 40. Right around the 48-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Fires complete over the middle. And down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
First down.
They come out in a five-wide set. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to lift the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From the 21-yard line, first down. Sub package in there defensively in this five wide receiver set. Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made around the 21-yard line. And he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21. He's under some heat. Well, the stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. And I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room. We have less than a minute to go. So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these two teams do.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
From their own 13-yard line, it's second down.
He's into the open field. Makes it to the 24.
And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. USC 41, Colorado State 10. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.